Hello there, it's Thursday the 1st of December 2016. That's it now, 24 days to go before Christmas Eve and then Christmas Day. Yes, ding dong merrily on high, in heaven the bells are ringing. As always, gang, if it's your birthday today, that's coming up during the show this evening, okay? Or this morning, this afternoon, whenever you're watching it. And I, as you can see, I didn't manage to get an advent calendar. Sorry about that. We were going to get a little advent calendar, weren't we? But it didn't manage. Someone actually gave me one last week after the quiz. One of the youngsters who came along and did a quiz just kind of handed it to me on the way out. I think he was probably giving it to him, but didn't want it. But it's still in the car. Things do take a long time for some reason to get from the car into my house. I don't know what that is. Wendy's, well, that lovely calendar, Wendy's still in the car. I don't know, or I might have bought it in. I don't know where I've put it. The lovely Wendy. Now, did I? I don't think I saw that in the car last night. I've put the calendar down somewhere in the house. I keep losing things at the moment. Do you think this is something I should go and see the doctor about? Losing things. Is it that Alzheimer's disease or something like that? Do you think I might? I don't know where I am half the time. I won't lie to you. However, Eamonn last night at the quiz. Now, Eamonn is a regular quiz player. There is a team that have been coming to the quiz since the very first one. They've never, ever missed a week, right? But the team changes. The members of the team change, usually headed by the great Johnny, who is an antique dealer, boys and girls, an antique dealer. There's usually Bruce there and the two ladies. Can't get the names. I'm sorry. Can't get the names. There's two ladies. Lovely ladies as well. They're going to kill me for that. And there's Eamonn as well. Now, last night there was Eamonn and two new people who I haven't seen. The team was much smaller than usual. And Eamonn won. They are the team that has won the most amount of times. That's not to say they win a lot. They do win more than everyone else, but they haven't won like loads. Like, say, for example, out of four quizzes, they don't win three of them. It's kind of one every, I suppose, one every 4 or 5 weeks or so, which is some doing. And the reason they've won so much is because they come every single week, you see. And last night, Eamonn won. The funny thing is, he was the only original member there. None of the others were there. So I do feel, Eamonn, that the others might be holding you back. Now, don't you dare tell him I told you that. It's only a joke. It's only a joke. Oh, God. Oh, I'll be walking in next week and there'll be knives waiting to be plunged into my back. Yes. And we had a good night in there last night because the theatre people, we have to be very careful that we're not too loud because in case the sound carries into the theatre. But it doesn't. And they've got double doors there. I mean, we can never hear the theatre. And they must be louder than us. So I assume that they can't hear us as well. Anyway, last night there was no show because they're getting ready for the pantomime. This is at the King's Head Theatre Bar in Upper Street in Islington. So I whacked it all up. Oh, what a night, dear. We did have a laugh last night. I did think at the beginning they were a little bit subdued. People were subdued in there last night, full of very, very intelligent university people who take a while to get used to you. Do you know what I mean? They don't quite get me when some of the stuff I come out with. And there was, once again, there was a television person sitting on the table right next to me, and we don't know who it was. Now, the only reason I knew it was a television person is because a couple of other young gay boys came over. Something went wrong there, gang. Here I am again. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. So I knew it was a television person because these two gay boys came over and started talking to him. Oh, where have we seen you? And he wouldn't tell him. He wouldn't tell him. So it must have been someone on the telly before again. Yes. I wonder who it was. How strange and mysterious. So that was last night, and congratulations to Eamonn's team of three, the short plank. Sometimes they have six, seven, and eight members, but he's done better on his own than they've ever done for ages. Well done, Eamonn! Yes, indeed. Now, the only thing is, dreadful journey getting there and dreadful journey getting back. Yesterday, I spent 2 hours and 5 minutes getting there and 1 hour and... 1 hour and 50 minutes getting back. It's happening again, isn't it? It's a blooming joke. So that's one, I'm just going to do some mental arithmetic. 1, 2, 3, 55. What? That's nearly 4 hours in the car yesterday to do a 2 hour job. I mean, it's a joke. Money's all right. I get 90 quid for that. I don't mind telling you, I get 90 quid for that. Which is, I mean, if you was to include the travelling time, I suppose that's not bad, is it? So say I left at 6 o'clock, didn't I? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 10:30, 11:30, 12:30. So that's, so that's my 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 30. So it's 6.5 hours for £90. So that's 6, that's 9, that's 10, so about £13 an hour, something like that. Oh, I don't do exact it. We're not doing points. It's not a mathematical test, dear. Incidentally, for those of you that say I'm doing math, no, that's incorrect. Incorrect here in the United Kingdom. It's maths or sums. It's not math. That's American. Nothing wrong with math, but that is American. Are you American or English? Oh no, we're European. Yeah, not for long, dear. Bye bye. So maths, I can't do exact maths, I'm afraid. I got unclassified. What? No, I didn't. I got E. What did I get? E for maths. Was it CSE or O level? I can't remember now. I think it was CSE. I wasn't very good at maths. But I can add up and take away. And believe me, if you owe me so much as a penny, I will remember that. That's the maths I can do when it comes to cash, dear. Now, talking of cash. So that was the dreadful, dreadful journey yesterday. Absolutely dreadful. There and back. And funnily enough, I opened my little email box this morning, boys and girls, which isn't actually a box. It's a thing on the computer screen. And it says here, look at this, on the website petrolprices.com. Now, this is a site where you can go on and find out what the petrol prices are near you. Now, I feel a little bit pointless, really, because generally it's a 2 pence per litre difference. So if you was to drive around, you'd probably save yourself about 70 pence a tank. However, saying that, I see some very, very expensive petrol prices in some of these places. The BP garages I go past in London are roughly about £1.20 a litre. That's for petrol. The petrol prices here in Bracknell at Sainsbury's are £1.12 a litre. So that's quite a saving. But generally, if you're looking in the same area, there's about a 2 pence price difference. But nevertheless, anyway, there's a story on there this morning. Look at this. This is what I'm saying to you about traffic. If you've sat in a traffic jam recently on Britain's roads, you're not alone. It will come as no surprise to anyone who regularly drives in the UK that our roads are very, very busy. But the proof is now in that they're actually the most congested in the whole of Europe. The proof comes from a study of European cities and is reported by the BBC, a data analyst organisation spent time studying traffic data. There are pinch points, that is traffic hotspots, where the drivers had to slow down to 35% or less of their exact expected speed for at least 2 minutes. And it turns out that here in the UK, we have 20,000 of these hotspots. And I must drive through every bloody one of them. It's true. Across the 21 cities studied, this is by far the highest number in any European country. Behind us, a long way, is Germany with only 8,517 hotspots. And Italy with just over 5,000. Now, I don't know if you've been to Italy. That looks pretty busy to me. Especially Rome. I'm incorrect there. That was incorrect. I'm going to have to do my incorrect sound. That was incorrect. I've only really been to Rome as one of the cities in Italy. So I don't know about the others. That looks busy enough. Italy has 5,000 hotspots. Without doubt, this means the UK, many drivers suffer more frustration on the roads than anyone else across the UK. And it goes on. Which of Britain's roads are worst? It says, unsurprisingly, here we go. Unsurprisingly, London is right at the top of the list. There you go. Oh, is it? It might be sneezing time, with the M25 singled out as the place in Britain where people are most likely to suffer gridlock. Oh, I've worked through the sneeze. Look at that. The worst hotspot of all is the northbound M25 between junctions 15, the M4, and 16, the M40. Now, that's interesting, because I've got to tell you, I don't really get stuck there. Now, isn't that strange? On the other hand, my TomTom sat-nav, I've got a TomTom sat-nav on my mobile phone. I don't have a standalone device, which I've had for a few years now. It was actually a gift. My friend, Ronny, bought me the program. No, you don't call them programs, do you? App. My friend bought me the app for my iPhone and also traffic updates for a year, which he bought a few years ago. Now, it's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. If you want me to recommend a sat-nav to you and you've got an iPhone, I don't know if it works on the other phones as well, but I can highly recommend the TomTom, okay? The TomTom sat-nav thing with traffic updates and camera updates. Now, these are separate things. So, number one, you buy the main app and then the maps just up the apps, update free of charge. Number two, you get your traffic news, which is about £1.49 a month. And then the speed cameras, which again is about £1. I don't know if it's 49. I don't think it's quite as expensive, but that's for something as a month. So once you've got the main program, the whole thing costs you around about £3 a month. And believe me, it's worth it. Even when I get in stuffic for even when I get stuck in traffic for a couple of hours, had I not have had the sat-nav, it would probably have taken even longer. I highly recommend the TomTom iPhone sat-nav thing, okay? Now, I've got a sat-nav in the car. My Toyota car has got its own sat-nav. The two cars ago, I had a Toyota sat-nav. Absolutely useless. Useless. And it's difficult to understand. The one on the TomTom is brilliant. It's so easy to understand. I don't understand why Toyota cannot get these sat-nav things working properly. I mean, I've sat in traffic with both of them on, and the TomTom says go that way, and the car one says go that way. If you follow the car one, you get traffic that it didn't tell you was already there. Don't know why that is. TomTom sat-nav, that's what you want. The worst spot of all, so that's what I've told you that. Scotland is next with Edinburgh Bypass. I'll tell you where else we got stuck. When we went to go and see the Barry Manilow concert in Cardiff. Oh, my God. The traffic there trying to get in Cardiff at 5 o'clock at night. You don't want to be on that road. Because, of course, it's the only road in, isn't it? It's the only way you can get there, down there. All right? So that's a bit of traffic news. It's not just me making it up. It's actually happening. And, of course, if you sit in traffic, you will know exactly what I mean, my darlings. All right? Okay. Here's an email from Adam the Plumber. Good morning, Adam, who rushed this in at 9 o'clock this morning. You were up bright and early doing your pipes, weren't you, Adam? Don't you hope you... Oh, do you ever get... You know when you've got your hand down someone's pipes? Do you ever get stuff up your nails when the glove breaks? Oh, no. You can never get rid of that smell, can't you? How disgusting. It's like going for a piece of toilet paper. Anyway, listen. Adam says, good morning, Mr. Reardon. Good morning, Adam. Just like just a quick message to say thank you for my ball, because he now has the original mirror ball. This is the second one. This is not the original mirror ball. No, it was a guy, Mike, in Brighton, who's watching a show one day and says, I'm really sorry, Chris, I've got OCD. Can you please get a new mirror ball? Because there was a couple of little bits of mirror that had fallen off. They drop. That's what happens as you get older. Things drop off. There are elderly people crawling around here because all their limbs have fallen off. They are. Be very careful. As you get older, things fall off. It's terrible. Terrible. Anyway, he says, thank you for my ball. I have been inundated with offers to purchase the mirror ball you gave me. I've had to get a cool hand, a call. You've put cool. Call, dear. C-A-L-L. A misspelling there, Adam. Very surprised. I hope you don't misspell on your invoices, dear. That's, I do like to write an invoice or two when I've done work. I have been inundated with offers. I have had to get a call handling centre to manage the calls. Good afternoon, Adams Mirabal. I'm afraid all our operators are busy at the moment. However, your call is important to us and you will be connected to a customer services representative as soon as one becomes available. Please hold the line. I wonder what they mean by hold the line. How can everyone just hold the line? What, you hold a piece of wire? When I was working for British Telecom, Directory Inquiries, and also Operator 100, can I help you? Or used to do different voices. Operator, can I help you? We were told you mustn't say hold the line because it doesn't mean anything. Doesn't mean anything. What, you hold a bit of wire? No one holds a bit of wire. Can you hold the line, please? Do you grab a bit of wire? No, of course you don't. Unless you're stupid. Are you stupid? Yes, my sister can't work telephones. Oh, let me tell you. So she's now got, I can't believe how bad my sister is about using phones. So she's just had her mobile phone repaired. It needed a new screen. Now, luckily, my nephew Gary is very good at doing this. He can replace mobile phone screens. How fabulous is that? Hey? And he says they are the smallest screws that, I wouldn't be able to see them. Probably not even with my expensive £10 Waitrose glasses here. They are so tiny, the screws. Anyway, he repairs them. And then she bought this phone case. Now, I haven't seen it, but I know it's on there. She's bought this phone case, which completely covers the phone in plastic. Now, the reason she's got this is because she drops phones down the toilet. She absolutely does. This is not a joke. She drops phones down. She said what happens is that she goes into the toilet and when she sits down, she forgets it's in her pocket. And then it just falls out into the toilet. That's why it's now completely encased in plastic. But of course, when you call her, you can't hear a word she's saying. Because she's got this thing in. But I don't understand it. Why don't you take it out the bloody case, dear? Look, sis. I'm going to demonstrate now. I haven't got a... Ooh, look at this. That'll do. Perfect. One moment, please. That will do. I'm going to demonstrate now, dear sister. Now, I hope you're watching this. I'm going to demonstrate now what happens when you put a piece of plastic over your phone and for the phone, read my microphone, because the phone has a microphone in it. Right, this is what happened. Right, can you hear me now, sis? How's that sound now? You see, you can barely hear me now. Now, this is what's happening to your phone, dear. I can't bloomin' hear you. Please, cut a hole in it or something, because it's absolutely useless. Your brother cannot hear you. And how am I supposed to hear your little voice? You know, when I say, what would you like for Christmas? I can't hear what you're saying. You could end up with just a box of oranges, couldn't you? Yes, there we are. Now let me remove this. And look at the difference that is. Do you understand what I mean? Oh, it's such hard work. It really is, dear. Oh, thank you, sis. Anyway, can we get back to this very important message? Look at the time. Christ, I had a whole load of stories here to tell you. I haven't got any very far over. And I've also got something to show you as well. Also, on the subject of... Oh, hang on a minute. So he's got a call handling centre to manage the calls. Who'd have thought one of your old balls would be so popular? Also, on the subject of attractiveness and seeing yourself, as in me, not as attractive, I can see where you come from. I look at myself and think that I'm not that good looking. Right? But I have people saying that I'm not that bad looking. As you know, I'm 43 years, 10 years younger than me. A little bit overweight, just a small bit, mind. Just a small bit, that's what it is. And I have problems with my teeth. Oh, the best thing was the other day. Did you see the show yesterday? Adam was taking a service because he's a minister. Sorry, Adam, I think you're... Are you known as a minister? Or is there another word for people in your church? Here's a, I hope you don't mind me saying, a minister in a spiritualist church in Lewisham. And he took a he took a service the other day and his teeth fell out while he was doing a speech. No, mustn't laugh. I would have had to relieve the church, Adam. I'm sorry. Anyway, he says, a little bit, I'm problems with my teeth, but I still find that guys say I am attractive. But I often say you can drop down dead. Gorgeous guy or girl with the worst attitude in the world. That, to me, is the most unattractive than it looks. Oh, some of them are dreadful. So they are, attitude is vile. I think I had a bit of it when I was good looking. I do think I had a little bit of it as well, to be honest. I found that if you tell yourself you're unattractive, you can lose your confidence and then you believe no one wants you and that you're not unattractive. That, Chris, is not the case. There is somebody for everyone. And as you know, I've known you for 27 years on and off. Ah, you have, dear. You have. But I think I honestly don't believe there is someone for everyone, Adam. Sorry, darling, I don't. I also see old people, you know, old, even older than me, and that is saying something, isn't it? Older than me, who are alone and always have been. So how can you say there like is someone for everyone? You know, don't agree with that. Sorry, Adam, we disagree. It's the first time we've ever disagreed on something. Anyway, boys and girls, just before the birthdays, I have purchased something. Yes, they have arrived. Look at this. My lovely new reindeer duvet set. Look at that. Reindeer are there. Ding dong merrily. Oh no, it's that Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer. And reindeer pillow as well had a very shiny nose. And if you ever let him, Rudolph would say, oh, and it's reversible as well. Little red and white checks on the other side. That is my actual bed that I have slept on. So nice and soft. Only 20 quid for that lot. Not bad, is it, eh? That's not the only one. Another one arrived. Look, same price. Look at this, 20 quid. Another one, look, nice and purple, mauve one. Where's the design? There's the design. And once again, you can get both of those on Amazon for £19.99. Lovely brassed flannelette cotton. Nice and warm. Nice, yes. Nice and cosy in bed. So there we are, okay. Maybe I could use my new flannelette sheets to try and attract someone into the house. Would that work? Would that work? The thought of a nice one, perhaps your... Perhaps at this very moment you're watching this programme and you're a little bit cold in those, you know, shiny sheets that we all use at summertime, feeling a little bit cold, they can't afford to turn the heating. Just think how lovely and warm and cosy my bed would be in. Just send an email with a picture of yourself and I shall make a selection from the many that no doubtedly will arrive. Okay, it's birthday time, boys and girls. Happy birthday this morning to... Jonathan Walmsley. Happy birthday, Jonathan. Doesn't say your age. I'll have to estimate your age at about 46, OK? Happy birthday, Jonathan. He works for Virgin Media. I got a good deal from Virgin Media yesterday, but no time to tell you about it today. I shall tell you about it on the next show, OK? Happy birthday to Peter J. Hollely, 31 years old and looking very good for 31, if you don't mind me saying something. Peter, happy birthday, 31. Stephen Artis, DJ extraordinaire. Stephen, I think still DJs probably more than me now because I gave most of it up and moved over to karaoke and quiz nights. I still do one job now, Stephen, but happy birthday, Stephen. The last time, when's the last time I saw you? I think that was in the Two Brewers, wasn't it? And the other little place that we used to go to, yes, in Liverpool Street. What fun that was with our little white towels. Happy birthday, Stephen. Happy birthday to David Newland. And of course to John Bronson, singer extraordinaire, who is 53 today. Happy birthday, everyone. Here comes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Thank you for watching and listening today, boys and girls. If it's your birthday, have a wonderful day. And I'll see you when we have another little chat, OK? Thanks for watching and listening. Bye-bye.